pronounced from parts unknown, the assassin. And in the blue corner at 234 pounds, from Richmond, Virginia, Buddy Landell.
The veteran, rugged competitor, the masked assassin, versus popular Buddy Landell, clad in the gray tights. Here's Bill Watts.
Aboard the assassin, without a doubt, one of the most experienced and feared men in wrestling. Buddy Landell, a young up-and-comer who's shown great promise here on Mid-South. You know, again, we will see the final moments of last week's bout with the assassin and Bob Roop against Ernie Ladd and Ted DiBiase. We're in a wild altercation where the referee was knocked down. The one-man gang came on the scene. The assassin had tried to headbutt DiBiase with some foreign object in his mask outside the ring. DiBiase blocked it and ran his head into the iron post, which admittedly should have been a disqualification, but so should the foreign object have been had it been caught on the assassin. The assassin, I thought, had his motors just wiped out and was struggling and falling down and heading toward the dressing room. Then in the altercation, he appeared back in, but he did a maneuver which I've never seen the assassin do. He loaded the boot, which is certainly the trademark of the grappler, Boyd Pierce, caught DiBiase with it, which stunned DiBiase. Naturally, DiBiase certainly wasn't looking for that from the assassin. And then he got out. And looking back at the film, you see the assassin in a full black outfit, full top, sleeves, everything. And when you see this playback, you will see that although the man had a yellow mask, the mask just like the assassin, he certainly did not have a shirt. And it was, again, the tactic of the grappler. So I think that's one thing you always have to be on guard for is the scheming and the intrigue, like Bob Roop claims, the man with a plan. Anytime he's involved, you're going to have to figure that he has got some safeguards or something to try to take advantage of something or to create a situation that he could possibly capitalize on. Going into a top wrist lock, Buddy Landell powering out, going into that top wrist lock with the assassin, the old master of ring wars, he knows that you can take a man's head, where his head goes, his body's going to go, but Buddy Landell shows that he says, you've got to earn my respect, he goes right up and fires into the assassin, but did he catch one then? Following his up, the assassin loading the boot. The assassin loading the boot, Boyd Pierce.
Bill, I was just fixing to say it never in my career had I ever seen the assassin load the boot.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, Boyd Pierce, these guys, these pros, they know how to cloud an issue, I'll guarantee you. When you got ring-savvy people like Assassin and Bob Roop, believe you me, they watched the replay, they watched the films of each week to scout their opponents, and I'm sure they heard our comments. Hammerlock, the assassin was a master of the hammerlock, you recall, when he was under the auspices of Rock Hunter with the angel. He would drive that in with that flat that's legal, that's all legal, powering into that high bicep tricep area, and now he drives that hammerlock forward. That's the excruciating hold. You can't go beyond a 45-degree angle with an amateur, but pro, you can go all the way home. It's a submission, and there Ralph Neely calls for the submission. Buddy Landell capitulated.
And the power and strength of the masked assassin with that hold applied gains a victory. We'll be back when action continues on Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.